So last session we have seen both dynamic table and static table as well. We have the static table. We have static table, which names are like that.
City.
We have static table city, state, and country. We have the static table. And one is users is the dynamic tables, which we have discussed, and I have given task all of you to create a SQL script, create table and all. I hope you all are, you have created. Now today we are going to create a project. For the project creations, we have to follow several steps. So first steps is step one, create a project. With below dependencies. First is Spring Boot Starter. Spring Boot Starter Web. Second, Spring Boot Starter Data JPA. Third, Spring Boot Starter Image Fourth one, Spring Boot Starter DevTools. You can add additionally Lombok dependency org. You can say this is the, these are the not starter, but you can, you have to download Lombok for the Gator setup. So this dependency, again we need to give the PostgreSQL. I'm using PostgreSDB here, so I'll use the PostgreSQL driver. So this is the first steps you have to follow. I am saving this into my system. Then second step, step two, you have to create all the packages which are we required layer wise. Com dot or whatever your company domain is, com dot. I'm putting in dot career. This is a base package in dot career. Then I'm starting from the resource. In dot career dot service. In dot career repo. In dot career dot entity. In dot career config, in dot career util. This much you have to work on. This you have to write this much package first of all, then you have to create step three. create entities as per tables. Then step 4.04, create repository as per entities. Now step 5, create interface and class for service layer. Then step 06, implement basic implement service layer. These layers needs to be follow. We have to follow the these steps. We have to write one by one. We will go through one by one. For that purpose, just give me a few minutes. As we discussed, we have start our second project, a mini project. We have created it. We need to select the dependency Java Mail Sender. We are using to send email from our project. Whenever we are creating a user, its username and password shoot out to his email. He will receive the email, or he or she, whatever the user is supposed to receive that email, and that email contains username and passwords. Whenever he or she sign up, then we are getting a Spring Security. We are not implementing here right away. Our later one, we can use the Spring Security. Lombok, Spring Dev Tools, Spring Web. We are using Postgres database, Spring Data JPA. That is fine. We have the dependency. Let's check it once. How many we require? Email, Data JPA, and Web. There are 4. And we have additionally written here the Spring Web, Spring Data, Email, and Dev Tools. Okay, that is fine. Now I'm putting here the next, finish. Now what is the next step? The next step is create packages which we required. So base package automatically will create. Now other resource means controller layer. Service, you know, repository means DAO layer, entity where we are creating our table structure, configuration where we are configuring the custom configuration for our project, like as a Swagger, Redis Cache, then Spring Security, whatever configuration we required, we will create those classes into the config. Now, what is the util? Suppose I want to send a functionality, a different functionality, which all the methods or all the projects supposed to be to use. So I am going to create it in a util package. So across all resources, it can use functionality, small functionality I am developing here. So email functionality I'm putting into the util. So this functionality can use all the resources and services. Just I'm going to open. Let's see. Here we have base package. Now I am right clicking on the base package, or I can click here Control N, but I'm not using the shortcut. So creating a package. So first package will be resource. Then next package will be service. So another package which we require, service IMPL. So we can discuss about the service IMPL also. service dot IMPL, then we have repository. Then we have entity. I am creating here another package called config. The next package is after the config, I am going to create here util. I have created this much packages. Now I am going to create classes. I am starting from the entity and repo. So I am going to create entities. So we know we have the three static table and one dynamic table. So total four entity we have to create. Entity is nothing but it is your table which is created in database whenever you run the your project. So I am going to create a class. I am giving name like as a country. Then next is states, then cities. These are we have created, and now fourth one is users. Last session we have discussed regarding this table structure, means we have discussed around how many fields should be there. So start with the country. Country should ID and country name. So I am creating in that fields. Private long ID private string country name. That's it. Now I am putting here header it data for generating base con default or zero argument constructor and getter setters. Then header it ID. I am making this ID as a primary key, and I don't want here any auto generated value, so I am not putting here the auto generation. Then we will start creating entity another states. So state has ID, state name and country ID. Private long ID private string state name, or I can put simply name private long country ID. Then I am making here address data. And one more thing is we have to mention here for the entity. So we have to write here entity as well. So this entity annotation makes this class as a entity which is eligible to create table into database. Now cities private long ID private string name private long state ID. Add the rate data. Add the rate
entity. We have created all four, three entities. Now fourth one we have to create it here. So I am creating as a private long ID private. Then what is another field in users? Let's check. First name, last name, string, first name, private, string, last name, private, string, email, phone, private, string, contact, private, string, DOB, private, string, gender, private, string, temporary password we are putting here, private, string, private, long, country ID, private, long, state ID, private, long, city ID. So I am putting here @data, @ entity. So here we have completed our steps. Whatever we mentioned, step start, third we have completed. Now step fourth, we will start. We need to create a repo for these entities. So I'm going to create a repo. Sir.
Hello.
Yes. Sorry. Hello, Vivek. Vivek, are you saying something? Just a moment. Next, we will start creating the repo. Just we are creating new interfaces. Giving name is country, repo. We can extend that particular interface directly using here. How I can just go here, add its implementation. Just write a JPA, JPA repository, find your implementation. While the creation, you can implement it and finish it. So manually, you don't need to go there and extend and all, but you have to put here some your class entity names. So your entity name is country. I'm putting here long. I have created a repo. You can make this as a repository for the documentation purpose, that will be fine, but it is not necessary here to put @ repository because of JPA repository has already @ repository annotation. So but for the documentation and understanding purpose, just you can write here @ repository. So we can use the annotation @ repository to mark this class as a repository. Now next one is state repo. We'll create a state repo. State repo. We can add from here also, but if I'm not adding, so I need to go here and extend JPA repository. Now I have to give the all entity name. We have created the state repo also. Now third is city repo. I am going to create a city repo. Extends JP repository. Long. You can make as a repository for the documentation purpose, not mandatory. Here also I am going to make. Extends JPA repository. Being here long. Give it the name add direct repository. Putting annotation. We have done the step fifth. Now we have starting step fifth one. We have done the step four. We have created all the repository. Now we are starting to create service layer. Okay, now I'm starting creating service layer. Here we have to create an interface. I'm going to create for the user, because this is our dynamic tables, and dynamic table we have to write all the logic into the service layer. So that's why I'm creating only users service, because rest of three are the statics. So we are not doing any operations, so we don't require any logic in that particular table, or hence we don't require any service layer for those static tables. So this is one of the most important part of your skills and knowledge, because of resource repo, those are the fixed, but this is a real-time working layer. You have to implement your logic here. This is a service layer. So we will discuss how many methods we require. This is a very important question. How many methods we required in user service at least, and what should be its return type, what should be its parameter, everything we have to decide here. So let's discuss it.